This is Pat Love with Pat's Two Cents, with another little tidbit, another warning about who's around the young ones of your family, whether they're your kids, your nephews, your grandkids, your neighbor's kids, whatever. You keep your eyes open. Listen to this. I already said we're living in the dark ages. We're living in the last days when sin has become an epidemic. Yeah, anyway, being a little overdramatic. But listen, when you have a person around your child, one of your adult friends, a relative even, and every time you say, give Uncle So-and-so a hug, or give Auntie Jane a hug, or whatever, and the kid is like, shh, you know, and they're acting like they got the creeps, like they're creeped out, don't force them. Because you could be encouraging something from the adult that is a sick pedophilia thing that they got that nobody knows about, because of course they keep that under lock and key. So I have seen, okay, let's talk about me. Yeah, that's a good one. I almost forgot about that. When I was 4 and 5, I stayed with my godparents when my mother was in the insane asylum. I would go to church with them. It's the only time in my life I went to church anyway. But the comical part is, you know, my family was heathen to the bone. So anyway, but here we are going to church with my godparents every Sunday. And every Sunday, the pastor would be at the door as we came in, or as we came out, whichever way. I cannot remember that detail. But I do remember that booger was always at the door. Mm-hmm. Well, he used to do this. And when I tell you, this man, nobody else did that with me, but this man gave me the heebie-jeebies. He gave me the creeps. I couldn't stand for him to touch me. I couldn't stand for him to show me any kind of affection. I couldn't even stand for him to talk to me. Everything in me would, if I were able to articulate my feeling, leave me alone, get away from me. That is just how turned off I was. Children pick up signals before they start being taught how to ignore their feelings by adults. All right. Now here I was, and we get to the door, and he reached down and take my hand, and he lifted it, and I would be like, oh. If your child, I believe to this day, that man had a pedophilia spirit, because that's the ickiness I felt. It wasn't an ickiness of somebody who just was ugly, or they stunk, you know, or I just didn't like their personality. They were mean. No, this man gave me the creeps. Like, I would never want to be alone with him. I picked up on that big time. And I didn't even know what a pedophilia was. We didn't hear about that crap when I was that age. Come on. So my point to you is, if your discernment levels are in a coma, I said a coma. And if your child shrinks back and starts to get withdrawn when they get around certain adults, you start keeping that adult away for a while. See if you can drum up a nice little friendly conversation where your child feels comfortable telling you why they feel the way they feel. Now, it may be a case where nothing has jumped off, like with me. Nothing happened, but I picked up on it. I would have cried my eyes out. I would have screamed bloody murder if they had said, you're going to stay with your pastor this afternoon. So if your child is withdrawn, bound, overly quiet, and they act like they just don't really want the person touching or hugging or even talking to them, don't force them. Please don't. There are so many, you know, and I know from experience, most of us, you looking at me and I'm one of them. I know what it's like to be molested by an adult. So you have to be careful who you let come to your house, around your kids. Satan is he's trying to destroy quickly now. His time is up. And he's going to take as many as he can with him. If he can get people messed up in the head, filled with hurt, anger, unforgiveness, resentment, bitterness. Come on, demons. I got one for you here. Pack her up. Load them up. Get them ready for me. Good and ready. And you make sure they turn from God while you're at it. They start bringing assignments. You can't just allow. Listen, women too. Listen, you women. When you are so, I'm going to share a story what my father told me one time. But when you are so desperate. Yes, yeah, said it. I used to be. So I know what it's like. I'm not being insulting. It just happens to be a fact of life. Many women tend to be desperate. So what the Bible calls them, silly. Women, wanton, needy. Silly, desperate, and needy. You tend to hook up with the wrong one. Your discernment level has been laid aside for the sake of your ego, because you need this man's attention so badly that you will settle for anything. A piece of man is better than not having any man at all. Yeah, if you say so. In the meantime, you're putting your child at risk. Well, now you resent the child, because why should you have to look after the child when you don't have anybody there to fill your needs? You've got needs. Oh, stop it. Your first responsibility is to that child. And if you can't think that way, you're not grown up. You're still a child yourself. Listen, there are women who will drop their kids for the sake of a piece of a no good, good for nothing man. My father used to call them good for nothing jokers. And these women were sniffing and brown nosing, serve and step and fetch and let them hump her. Give him money, whatever, buy him stuff just to keep him around. So she can show the world she's got a man. You ain't got a man, baby. You got a leech. And that man's about to leech on the life of your child. But you're so busy thinking about you. Okay, let me get away from that. You got some men. Some of you men are way too trusting with your buddies. You let your buddy sit around, drink beer. Your daughter is walking. You get the daughter to go fetch the beer for you and your buddies. And one of your buddies is sitting up there eyeballing that piece of meat. They don't see him as your daughter. They're looking at something they could hump one day. But they got to set up the right scenario. Like, hey, man, I'll pick up your daughter from school. I am telling you. There is a warning. I'm just putting out a warning. You guys, don't let everybody be there around your kids. Not everybody is safe. Not everybody is. So you have got to watch, pray, discern, guard, protect by all means possible. Even if it means you have to cut down your level of friendships. If you have to cut some buddies out of your life, cut them loose, buddy, before they jack your daughter's life up, before they screw your son's head around. Okay, I'm done with the warning on that subject. I just hope you heard it loud and clear, not only with your ears, but with your heart and your spirit. God bless you with the spirit of discernment. in the name of Jesus.